Hello, Lakewood. How's everybody? Hey, family and friends, welcome. Well, I guess you figured it out by now that that was me, a younger 12-year-old version of me singing in the teenage choir back in Columbus, Ohio, where I'm from. And I'm telling you, I loved singing in that. I couldn't wait to get into that choir. They even changed the rules from having to be 13 to 12 so that I could get into it because I just loved it so much. And you know, I've always been drawn to music, especially vocals, vocal harmonies, and vocal arrangements. And I tell you, even at an early age, it was apparent, even to my family and to others, that God had given me this gift of song. And as I grew up, I was cultivating the gift, practicing, singing around the city with my family. And I realized that there was this increased sense of anxiety and fear that started to present itself. And although I know it's normal for people to be nervous, especially when you're standing in front of people, either speaking or singing, but for me, at times, it was almost debilitating, to be honest. And I noticed that I started to feel this feeling more frequently and on a more intense level. It was this serious tug of war that was on the inside of me. So here it is. I have this voice that's seemingly beyond my years, that's blessing people, and yet I didn't really have the self-confidence to match that. And so what was I supposed to do in this moment? People wanted to hear me sing, and yet there was this intense struggle on the inside of me. And I remember hearing this scripture, and it's a very familiar one that everyone has heard, I'm pretty sure. If not, I'll share it with you. And it's 2 Timothy, the first chapter, the 7th verse, and it says that God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. How many of you heard that scripture before? Yeah. And when I heard it, you know, I heard the scripture and I started meditating on it. And I was reminded that God, he wasn't orchestrating this fear and this torment in my life. That this presence was coming from an opposing force. And it was opposite of the peace that I experienced when I was in the presence of God. And I remember hearing the use of the word in an acronym, fear, at the word itself. And Pastor Lisa, she ministered not too long ago about it. And it stands for false evidence appearing real. And that's definitely what was happening. It wasn't real at all. But I believe that fear's intent and assignment was to keep me immobile and to keep me silent, because singing would be such an intricate part of how I expressed God's love, his grace, and his heart to God's people, but also a way that I would express my worship and my love to God. And I'm telling you, I believe that it was trying to stifle and overtake the light that I believe that God wanted to shine through me as I was singing in the video. There's a wonderful scripture that talks about the light. It's Matthew, the 5th chapter and the 16th verse, that says to let your light so shine before men so that they might see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. So glorifying God and bringing glory to him became my motivation. As a matter of fact, it was greater than the fear that I felt and I experienced. So I prayed to God and I asked him to help me to overcome these challenging moments. And as my relationship with the Lord grew, so did my faith and my trust in him. And I started feeding my faith, as Pastor just wonderfully ministered about last week. And I started to starve the fear that was trying to control my life. And the next thing that was important for me to do was to take bold, courageous steps of faith and to face the giants that presented themselves to me. I noticed that every time I did this, that I could actually feel the grace and the strength of God And every dark presence that was there would automatically flee as I submitted to God and I resisted. So today I stand thankful and grateful and victorious because I know that many of the blessings, I'm telling you, many of the blessings that I'm experiencing today are a direct result of the moments that I decided to say yes to God. I've been so blessed over my life to do so many wonderful things. I've been able to record and to do music, produce music, to travel all over the world. And I'm currently one of the worship leaders at one of the most amazing churches in the world. Come on, give it up for Lakewood. Woo! What a blessing it is to be here. I really love our pastors and the leadership here. The one thing I'm extremely grateful for, is that obedience to God led me to Nashville, Tennessee, where I met my lovely, beautiful, amazing wife, Tammy, who's right here on the front row. And we have three amazing, wonderful children. I love Anaya. She's not with us right now, but love her so much. But I would have missed out on so many of the great moments in life had I listened to fear. So today, my objective and what I would love to do is to just encourage you, those of you that have experiencing what I've experienced, to take faith action in the direction of God's word and what he's spoken to you. I want to encourage you to seize every moment and every opportunity and know that God is with you and that he is empowering you. I promise you will soon realize that the fear that seemed to be this impenetrable, massive brick wall was actually nothing more than just a smoke screen. You can do it. I believe you can do it. You are victorious. Step out on faith today. Amen. God bless you. It's all right. I'd like to pray for you. I was so blessed after sharing this morning that there were a few people that came up to me and they said, you know what? That's what I needed. I needed that boost to help me to move forward. There's some opportunities ahead of me and I've just been stuck. And you may be here today and I want to say a quick prayer for you. Is that all right? Heavenly Father, I thank you for everyone that is here under the sound of my voice. And I thank you for this wonderful opportunity to share my story. I thank you, Lord God, that faith is being increased in everyone that's here. And I see the business plans and I see the dreams and I see everything that is before you. And for some reason, there's always this nagging voice of fear trying to convince you that it's not for you. But I just want to let you know that God is saying it is and that he's given that to you. And he wants to get glory out of your life. You may be a singer. You may be a business entrepreneur. You may be even a homemaker. Whatever it is that God places on your heart, believe in faith. Move out in the things that God has spoken to you. And I thank you, Lord, that the voices of fear are being silenced right now. And I thank you that there will be no more turmoil, no more torment in your life, but you will be free and released to be all that God has created you to be in Jesus' name. If you receive that today, let's give the Lord a great, 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 great praise today. Amen. Well, since I'm up here, I might as well sing a song, huh? I'm so grateful. You know what? Before I step on stage, every time I tell the Lord that I need him, I don't do this out of my own flesh and out of my own talent, but I really, really need God's presence. And the Lord gave me this course years ago, and I met with William Garcia, who's right here on the piano right behind me. He helped me to pull it all together and finish it. And this is actually one of my first times actually singing it. I want to do that today with the wonderful background vocals and our music here. And Michael Hodge. Everybody put your hands together for Michael Hodge. He's going to help me today. So be blessed by this song, I Need You. Thank you. Oh yeah. As the glory of the moon is the mere reflection of the light from the sun, I'm made in the image of you. Oh Lord, I belong to you. And as the earth receives the rain, an essential need of every living thing, my heart is thirst after you. Oh Lord, I belong to you. Oh, I can't imagine life without you. I need you. I'm desperate. There were many ups and downs, but there's one thing I know, that you were always there with me, Lord. My guiding light, you're my everything. Oh, can't imagine. Ooh, say, Lord, I need you. For you. Oh, how many of you need the Lord in here today? Hey, oh yes, as the deer panting after the water brook, this is what the song says. So my soul thirsts for you, Lord. I need you. Say, I need you. Say.